Assalamualaikum and good day. Today we're going to start with chapter 4, pre-stress concrete. Okay, what is pre-stress? So pre-stress concrete is a technique that greatly increases load bearing strength of concrete beams. Pre-stress concrete is basically concrete in which stresses of the suitable magnitude and distribution are introduced so that the stresses resulting from external load are counteracted to desired degree. Pre-stress is commonly introduced by tensioning the steel reinforcement either prior to the concreting called pre-tensioning or after concrete has hardened by keeping steel bars in sheathing called post-tensioning. So sebenarnya pre-stress concrete ni satu cara lah, one way untuk increase load-bearing strength concrete beams ni lah. Maksudnya they increase the strength eh. How they do that? By tensioning the steel reinforcement ataupun kita boleh juga panggil the steel tendon. So kalau sebelum, maksudnya kita buat tu sebelum concrete to harden, kita panggil dia as pretension. And kalau after concrete to harden, we call it as post tension. So this is one way cara nak increase the strength of the concrete beams. Or any other structural elements. Contohnya yang selain daripada tu kita buat juga dekat slab. Ada juga yang buat dengan pada girder eh. Kalau reinforced concrete girder, ada juga yang pakai this kind of method. If compression is created in a concrete section before or simultaneously with the application of loads, tensile stress could be eliminated. Okay, this is the principles of pre-stressing. As you can see, so this is a normal reinforced concrete with bars. If you see down here, kat sini ada bar. Okay, but this is normal eh. If typical load being applied on the top of the beam ataupun any other concrete element eh, crack with deflection under that load and full service load. So kalau you tengok dekat bawah ni akan ada cracking. Kalau katakan you letak load yang lebih lah. Okay. However, if you use the pre-stress concrete, so this one, kalau gambar ni adalah only that load lah, which is the load that the self weight of the beam itself lah. Okay. So that load ni self weight dia sendiri without any other live load. Okay. Jadi hanya ada that load saja. So sebenarnya kalau tanpa load yang lain, the beam ataupun any other concrete element tu dia akan melengkung macam ni eh, dia curve. Okay. Tapi if let's say you letak loading dekat atas, so beam ni takkan ada deflection. Okay, which means dia balance balik because of the loading that coming from above, maybe being transferred to the beam. Okay, daripada slab ke contohnya pergi pada beam. Okay, then the loading tu akan counter balik melengkung ni, so terus jadi cantik straight je macam ni eh. So itu principle dia. It's a method in which compression force is applied to the reinforced concrete section. Okay, the effect of pre-stressing is to reduce the tensile stress in the section to the point till the tensile stress is below the cracking stress. Thus the concrete does not crack. Because if let's say kita tak buat this pre-stressing, normally dekat bahagian bawah beam atau concrete element you akan cracking eh, sebab beam bila letak full service load dia akan melengkung kat bawah tu, deflection, so it will cause crack. But with pre-stressing, it will eliminate the possibility of cracking. It is then possible to treat concrete as an elastic material. So because of pre-stressing, beam ni akan jadi macam elastic material lah. Okay, the concrete can be visualized to have two compressive force, which is internal pre-stressing force. So kalau pre-stress ni akan ada force daripada pre-stressing itself. Okay, and also from the external force, for example that load, live load, lateral load and others lah, etc. Eh. These two force must counteract each other. So bila internal pre-stressing force, meaning because contohnya the beam ni like this, okay, so because of you pulling out the bar atau the tendon tu from outside dekat outside sini, so dia menarik keluar, so beam akan jadi melengkung macam ni lah. Okay, force dia akan jadi macam ni. But bila you put on force from above, okay, so dia akan balance, dia akan jadi macam ni balik lah. Okay, so itu principles of pre-stressing. When the stress in concrete, when pre-stressing is applied to the center of gravity of the section. If you can see from the diagram, the pre-stress tendon is actually located in the middle section of the rectangular beam. So what happened due to the pre-stressing force, okay, this is apa kita panggil stress diagram yang you ada belajar sebelum ni masa chapter 2. Okay, pre-stressing force, kalau you tengok, okay, dia ada positive on the compression force and also positive on the tensile force, tensile stress, okay, compressive stress and tensile stress. And this is stress from the dead load and this is stress from the live load. So kalau you tengok large compression on the very top of the beam, okay, ataupun concrete element lah yang lain-lain, okay, but very little or no tension yang dia boleh produce daripada pre-stressing ni. Okay, but if you put the tendon ataupun bar tu, reinforcement tu, okay, below the center of gravity. Center of gravity here, so you put it down here, so dia ada eccentricity. Ini kita panggil eccentricity So pre-stressing force, okay, ini kalau you letak dekat center of gravity, dia akan produce this one. But bila you letak dia punya reinforcement ataupun tendon reinforcement ni below the center of gravity, letak dekat bawah ni, okay, kat sini lah yang ditunjukkan diagram dia, okay. Compression dia akan jadi minus, okay, but the tension akan increase kat bawah ni, tensile stress. Compressive stress dia akan minus dekat atas. Okay, and then stresses from dead load and live load, and it will produce smaller compression above, okay, lebih balance lah, and smaller compression below. So in pre-tension, pre-stress concrete, so ini kan dia ada pre-tension and post-tension. So first we will look at the pre-tension, pre-stress. In pre-tensioning, length of steel wire or cables are laid in empty mold and stretch. So you have like mold lah kat sini, mold ya, and then stretch. The concrete is placed and allowed to set, and the cables are released. So dia ada jacking system dekat sini, okay, dia anchor dekat tendon ataupun anchorage ni, tendon ni being anchored dekat sini lah. Okay, so dia akan jack, dia akan tarik And the cables are released. So after the concrete the being placed, cable ni release. Placing the concrete into the compression as the steel shrinks back to its original length. Okay, and then we look at the post-tension. For post-tension pre-stress concrete, the tendons are stressed and each end is anchored to the concrete section after the concrete has been cast. Right, so here tendons ni, tendon tak ada kat sini, okay, ini contoh tendon ni lah, okay, dia being stressed first and each end is anchored at the concrete section after the concrete has been cast and has attained sufficient strength to safely withstand the pre-stress force. The tendons are encased in flexible metal hose. So ini adalah hose metal hose ni, or duct, and remains in the structure. So metal hose ni dia memang remain dekat dalam ni, dia takkan dikeluarkan tapi kiranya tendon ni diletakkan dekat dalam hollow duct untuk tendon lah. So maksudnya hollow duct ni dia ada tendon dekat dalam ni, Okay, being placed dekat dalam tu. After the tendon has been stressed, so tendon ni akan stress, the void between the tendon and the sheath is filled with grout. So after dia dah you dah stress the tendon itself, lepas tu you akan masukkan grout lah dalam ni supaya dapat isi kekosongan antara hollow duct tu dan tendon ni lah. Okay, ni contoh hollow duct. Okay, kalau nampak. And then ni tendon ni. So, dia being stressed first. Okay. Lepas dah being stressed, grout ni akan dimasukkan dekat dalam ni lah. Advantages of pre-stressing. Take full advantages of high strength concrete and high strength steel. Basically, what they use higher strength for steel and concrete compared to normal RC. It needs less materials. Okay. Smaller and lighter structure because of kita increase the strength, so kita dapat reduce the size of the components itself, and then no cracks lah, obviously. Use the entire section to resist the load because of kalau you tengok the distribution of the stresses tadi memang balance eh, lebih balance daripada normal RC elements. And then better corrosion resistance because kita memang letakkan tendon itself memang encase betul-betul dekat dalam the component eh, memang letak dekat dalam, so dia lebih tertutup dan tak mudah exposed to the environment. And then very effective for deflection control since kita pun dah nampak kan tadi, because of bila dia balance, so component tu memang tegak lah, as in dia akan jadi tegak macam ni eh, dia takkan deflect like this. Okay. And then better shear resistance. Alright. However, there are disadvantages also. Limited builders experience with work of pre-stressing. So, tak ramai yang boleh buat. More expensive and materials fabrication at delivery etc. So, contohnya kalau macam post-tensioning, sometimes diorang akan buat dekat dalam factory. So akan ada cost lah untuk delivery components itself. For example, if you use it for beams, then you have to deliver it to site. Dalam, maksudnya dia akan jadi satu component. Dia akan jadi beams, biji macam tu, pre-stress beam, bawa ke site macam tu. So dia besar lah, components yang besar dan you need to deliver to site eh, because of the fabrication is off-site. And then heavy precast member require large crane, so because of maybe dia being prefabricate outside, jadi perlukan equipment ataupun machinery lah, contohnya macam crane untuk angkat the component, and then you nak assemble on-site eh. Site management is very important. Small margin of error because of kalau katakan it is prefabricated outside, jadi component tu you kena macam pasang Lego lah. So bila pasang Lego, kalau katakan ada salah sikit je, so tak fit, then you cannot install it together like that eh. So this is the formula for pre-stressing. Okay, this is the main formula. P equal to Mx divide by Z divide by A minus E. Okay, P itself adalah minimum pre-stress force. So maksudnya yang kita cari sekarang ni berapa force yang kita perlukan untuk pre-stress the concrete kalau katakan you have this kind of moment, which is kita derive daripada Mmax ni lah. A is the area. Okay. Z is the section modulus at the bottom of the beam. Okay. And then E is the eccentricity of tendon bar. So Mmax, kita kena dapatkan berapa value Mmax ni using the formula of WL square over 8. Why WL square over 8? So normally the transfer, for example beam eh, like this, loading yang being transferred to the beam, okay, dia adalah UDL, uniformly distributed load eh. So bila uniformly distributed load, okay, maksudnya loading tu kan daripada slab, contohnya dari slab eh, being transferred to the beam. So this is slab lah. Okay. Jadi the transfer to beam dia adalah UDL sebab dia sama kan. Sama-sama like this. Okay. So since UDL, bila you kira for the maximum bending moment, okay, bila contohnya you have one UDL only, tak kisahlah berapa-berapa, okay, W kilonewton per meter, okay. So ini adalah dia punya force, okay. And then kalau you lukis the SFD, okay, perhaps you akan dapat something like this, okay. So bila you kira dia punya BMD, you akan dapat maximum bending moment, berapa value kat bawah ni. So berapa value kat bawah ni adalah this coming from this diagram eh. Ini adalah dia punya dari segi formula. Kalau katakan you ada UDL, simple as this lah. Maksudnya force tu adalah simple macam ni je. Loading yang being transferred to the beam tu simple as this. So it is very easy for you to calculate maximum bending moment without the need to draw SFD and BMD. You boleh pakai formula ni terus. Okay, you akan dapat jawapan sama. Kalau you lukis pun jawapan dia tetap sama. Right? And then we have Z equal to BD square over 6. So Z ni adalah section modulus at the bottom of the beam. Ataupun Z ni kita panggil dia juga as a elastic modulus eh. Section modulus adalah elastic modulus. So Z ni kalau katakan you the cross section of the beam is just simple petak macam ni, okay. Okay, kita boleh terus pakai formula Z equal to BD square over 6 untuk dapatkan modulus of elasticity dia. Okay, tapi kalau katakan section U like T section like this. Tapi dalam pre-stress concrete kita tak belajar lah like this T section semua eh. But if let's say T section like this, normally yang macam maybe like being prefabricated dekat dalam factory like that kan, benda yang dah ada. So normally dia dah ada section modulus yang masing-masing. Section modulus ni sebenarnya dia depends daripada the cross section of the component itself lah. Kalau cross section dia just simple rectangular, so you just boleh pakai formula ni untuk dapatkan the section modulus eh. So we look at example 1. How are we going to solve this? A pre-stressed concrete of section 300mm by 400mm and effective span of 5 meter, right? So you have like 300 by 400 effective span means the length is 5 meter. It is required to support an imposed load of 30 kilonewton per meter, means W is 30 kilonewton per meter. Find the magnitude of minimum pre-stress force required when the eccentricity is 0 and 80mm. Means 1, dia nak minta you. Okay, 1, dia minta you cari kalau eccentricity dia kosong. And B, kalau eccentricity dia is negative 80. Okay, we look at one by one how we're going to do this. But first, kita akan tengok look apa dia punya formula lah. Okay, so the formula again, P equal to Mmax divide by Z divide by A minus E. Kita tulis dulu the formula, P equal to Mmax divide by Z minus A, divide by A minus E. Alright, so sekarang apa yang dia minta sebenarnya, dia minta you cari P, berapa dia punya minimum pre-stress force. P berapa kalau E equal to 0 and kalau E is equal to negative 80. Negative here means dia bawah centroid eh. Because kalau tadi macam I cakap kan, eccentricity tu apa. So one eccentricity dia kalau dekat kosong maksudnya dekat betul-betul dekat centroid lah. Okay, so ini adalah kalau eccentricity adalah sama dengan kosong. Kalau eccentricity dia minus 80, okay, it means that, okay, because of centroid here, so centroid dia ni dekat sini kan. So maksudnya bawah daripada centroid ni Okay, adalah 80. So dia letakkan tendon tu dekat bawah ni. So kalau kat sini, tendon ni kat sini lah. Kita buat satu-satu eh. Okay, first kita kena dapatkan berapa value Mmax dia. Okay, so Mmax, the formula again, it is WL square over 8. Okay, tu boleh kira lah. So M is berapa? M is 30 kN per meter. W is 30 kN per meter. And then darab dengan length. So length, it says that it is 5 meter. Effective span eh, 5 meter. And then you will divide with 8. Then you will get the value. It is 93.75 kilonewton meter. We're going to find the value of Z. So Z is equal to BD square over 6. Okay. Check balik berapa value B and D. So B is 300 mm and 400. So better kita tukar dia kepada meter, sebab kita tak nak nanti nombor dia besar sangat eh. Sebab kalau you tengok dekat atas ni, sorry, kalau you tengok the value of force dia eh, force pula, moment, kita tengok value moment dia dalam kilonewton meter. Jadi sebenarnya lagi senang kalau kita convert dia kepada meter, right? So 0.3, sebab kita convert 300 mm to meter. And D adalah 0.4, sebab kita convert 400 mm to meter eh. And then divide with 6, I dapat 0.08 meter cube. So that is the elastic modulus ataupun section modulus of the beam. Okay, and then what we do next is we need to find the area juga. So area is, okay, area of the cross section lah sebenarnya. So kita ada B and D already. So 0.3 meter you darab je dengan 0.4 meter. So kalau you tengok semua I pakai meter eh. So kita maintain pakai meter je lebih senang, supaya bila kita kira nanti terus kita boleh cancel kan eh. 0.2 meter square. Yang dia nak tu adalah yang E, which is E adalah equal to 0. So masukkan je. Okay, divide kan dengan Z 0.08 meter cube. Bagi lagi A 0.12 meter square minus 0. Then you akan dapat terus jawapan dia 140.625 kilonewton. Sebab kalau you tengok ni meter cube, okay, dia bagi kat sini dia hilang. Ni tinggal 1, right? And then meter hilang dengan meter, so tinggal kilonewton eh. So ini adalah dia minimum pre-stress, minimum eh, pre-stress force required. B, when E is equal to negative 80, so 80 below the centroid, using the formula P equal to Mmax divide by Z over E minus Z over A minus E. Right, masukkan juga lagi. Just ganti je E tu dengan negatif 80. Yang lain-lain semua sama. Okay, minus E kan? So, minus 80. So, 80 mm. So, 80 mm kita tukar tu meter, so jadi 0.08 lah. So negatif 0.08. Then I dapat jawapan dia 125.558 kilonewton. So ini adalah jawapan kita yang terakhir. The first one, contohnya kalau you letakkan tendon tu kat tengah-tengah ni, so this is the minimum pre-stress force. Maksudnya force yang apa? Force yang you nak tarik beam tu dengan loading sebanyak 30 kN, panjang beam 5 meter ni, you nak tarik tendon tu, you need 140.625 force eh. You nak tarik dia, nak stresskan dia, you nak tarik dia keluar, nak pull out dia, you perlukan sebanyak 140.625. Okay, kalau katakan you letak dia below 80 mm, below the centroid, you letak tendon dekat sini, letak tendon dekat sini, then you just need as much as 125.558 untuk support loading sebanyak 30 kN per meter ni. Kalau you compare between these two, using the one yang below ni lah, maksudnya ada eccentricity ni lebih bagus lah compared to kalau you letak dekat centroid. Okay. Right, so kita tengok pada example number 2. Example number 2, a rectangular concrete beam 300 mm by 600 mm is pre-stressed by means of 14 mm diameter high tensile tendons located 200 mm below the soffit of the beam. Okay, you have this kind of 300 by 600. And then ada 14 mm diameter high tensile tendon. Okay, so centroid dekat sini. Okay, 200 daripada below, ada 4 tendon. Right, size dia 14. If the effective stress in the wires is 700 newton per mm square, what is the maximum bending moment that can be applied to the beam section without causing tension at the soffit of the beam? Kalau you tengok, dia minta you cari maximum bending moment, which is W. Okay, so dia minta you dapatkan W. So how we going to do this? As usual, kita write down the formula. Sekarang kita nak cari M max eh. Kita bukan nak cari P. P ni dia dah given. Okay, sebenarnya P ni daripada value ni, you nampak ada the effective stress in the wires is 700 newton over mm square. Maksudnya untuk 1 mm square, okay, stress dia adalah sama dengan 700 newton. Okay, so sekarang berapa mm besar tendon tu. So kita kena cari area tendon tu berapa, so that kita boleh darabkan dengan 700 newton over mm square ni eh. So we know that the diameter adalah 14 mm, right? And then dia ada 4 numbers. Okay, jadi kita akan kira area dia, dapatkan berapa value P ni eh. So P actually adalah 4 numbers of 14 diameter tendon. Okay, so 14 diameter, kalau kita kira area dia, kita kena darabkan dengan radius lah, 7 mm power of 2 eh. Okay, sebab kita nak dapatkan dia punya area. So ini sekarang area tendon tu, okay, pi r square kan, and then kita darabkan dengan 700 newton over mm square, sebab kita tahu 1 mm square adalah bersamaan dengan 700 newton stress dia eh. Dapatkan berapa value P. Here I dapat 431.512 newton eh, sebab mm ni dah kuasa 2, dah pangkah lah. Okay, dah pangkah newton. Right, so ataupun you boleh tukar dia kepada kilonewton lah, 0.027 kilonewton. So this is the force, minimum pre-stress force. And then kita nak check Mx, so kita perlukan value of Z. Okay, Z is equal to BD square over 6. Okay, so B is 300 mm by 600 mm. 600 mm adalah D, convert into meter. So 0.3 meter times 0.6 meter power of 2 divided by 6. Value is 0.018 meter cube. Right, and then we need the value of A. So A is area beam tu eh. So 0.3 meter darab dengan 0.6 meter. 0.18 meter square. And then, okay, kita boleh masukkan so part 31.027 dekat P, right? And then Mx, this is the value that we need to find. Okay, and then Z is 0.018 divided by 0.18 meter square and minus with E. So eccentricity dekat sini is not 200 ya, sebab sebenarnya dia kata high tensile tendon located 200 mm from the soffit of the beam. So soffit tu sebenarnya paling bawah lah, base of the beam. So paling bawah ni daripada jarak daripada paling bawah adalah 200. So kalau beam ni dia height is 600, okay, so centroid dekat sini tendon tu dekat 200. Okay, so sebenarnya jarak ni adalah balance dia tinggal 100 eh. Sebab beam ni bagi 2, 300. So sebenarnya eccentricity tu adalah distance tendon tu ke centroid. So berapa distance yang ini, bukan ke soffit of the beam. Sebab yang ni dia 200 ni dia bagi sampai soffit of the beam. Tapi you nak kan sebenarnya eccentricity ni maksudnya jarak yang inilah. So eccentricity adalah 100 mm. Okay, so E is 100 mm. Then you have to convert into meter. So convert into meter divide by 1000, then you akan dapat 0.1. So because of the below the centroid, so you kena tak negatif lah kat depan. So 0.1 meter. Right, so you bolehlah kira dapatkan value of Mx. So kalau susah, okay, kira semua ni and then you alihkanlah everything yang dekat sini, yang dekat sini alihkan pergi sana. Okay, you kira dulu and then you alihkan ke sana, darab dengan 431 tu you akan dapat berapa value Mx. I dapat 86.205 kilo newton meter, right? So itulah sebenarnya cara you kira lah. But kalau kat ikut kat sini, so ini kan dia per meter kan, so bila you darab ke sana, so meter tu you bawa ke kilo newton tu, so dia jadi kilo newton meter. So that is the final answer. This is the maximum bending moment that the beam can actually support with this kind of size and also dengan pre-stress force sebanyak 431.027 ni lah. Okay, and then we look at the next example, which is example number 3. A rectangular beam of 300 mm by 150 mm is simply supported over a 4 meter span. Kalau you tengok dekat sini, jangan confuse eh, bila 300 atau 150 ke, macam mana sekalipun dia susun all this thing, mana 150 kat depan, 150 kat belakang. Yang paling pendek ni adalah B eh, dan yang tinggi ni adalah D. Okay, so jangan terbalik. And then and support a life load of 10 kilonewton meter. If a straight tendon is provided at the centricity of 65 mm below the centroid, so C adalah negative 65 mm. Calculate the minimum pre-stress force necessary for no tension under live load at mid-span. Right. So senang je lah macam mana nak buat eh. So support live load of 10 kN per meter and blah blah blah. So simple je. To answer this question, basically apa yang cari you nak kira macam example number one eh. Kita boleh tulis dulu formula. So P equal to MX divide by Z over A minus E. Then kita akan kira berapa value MX using the live load yang dia dah bagi, which is here it is 10 kilonewton per meter. So live load ni adalah loading lah kan. So 10 kilonewton per meter and span dia adalah 4 meter. Right. So masukkan je 10 kilonewton per meter kan, and then darab dengan dia punya length which is 4 meter. Kena tulis formula dulu. Okay, so W adalah live load tu 10 kilonewton per meter, and then darab dengan the length which is 4 meter, power of 2, and you divide by it and you will get the value of MX. Here I dapat 20 kilonewton meter. Then kita kira the Z, value of Z, which is BD square over 6. Masukkan je berapa B and berapa D. Tengok balik soalan. So B is 150 and D is 300. Okay, convert into meter. And I dapat 0.0002 meter cube. Right, and then the value of A is 0.15 meter times with 0.3 meter, which is 0.045 meter square. Right, then masukkan dalam this formula. And then check balik berapa value of eccentricity given the question. It says that straight tendon is provided at the eccentricity of 65 mm below the centroid. Maksudnya negative 65 mm lah. So negative 65 mm tukar kepada meter. So jadi negative 0.065. Okay, so kita boleh calculate berapa value P. Okay, so the value of P is 182.741 kilonewton. Right? So settle lah kita punya masalah ni. Okay, itu saja for example number 3. Alright, so this is the end of this chapter sebenarnya, but during the tutorial class, we're going to do some exercise lah. Okay, so itu saja. Thank you so much. Hopefully everyone understand. Have a nice day. Bye.